Okay, Smooch is in training with Elise. And he's being such a good boy. She's been riding him for about 10 minutes already. What did he spook from over there?
What was he spooking at?
Yeah.
The dressage clothes.
Oh, yeah. He doesn't
like
stuff with letters, I don't know. Or white poles. He'll eventually get over that shit though, right? He will go over those for Gina, so he should. He won't for me, but he will for Gina. Very nice. Good job.
He always takes like a second to look at it.
Right? He'll sidestep over it before he'll walk over it. He likes to sidestep though.
Good boy.
Look at that. Good, good job, buddy. Good boy. Oh, I should stop talking to him.
Okay.
That's good. He's listening so well for you. I love my horse, he's so pretty. So Elise is riding him for half hour, one day a week, before I ride, to help work out issues. Not his issues, really my issues, but. Because as you can see, he's a really good boy for her. So the problem is me, and me not knowing what to tell him or how to tell him or whatever. He's really being a good boy for her.
That was really nice.
Yeah. Were you telling him to stop or was he stopping because he didn't want to do it?
I asked him.
Okay.
And I asked him to trot off from a standstill and he did.
That's awesome. So what did you do to tell him that? I don't know what that means.
That's kind of an indicator almost.
What does that mean? I mean, what do you mean you picked up your contact?
Like, I picked up my rein.
Oh.
So when I stopped him and I asked him to stop, after he stopped, I kind of let my reins go so he could have his head. And then I picked them back up and I put my legs on and I squeezed and he trotted off. See, I barely even put my legs on that time and he walked off.
So I thought when you pick up the reins and put your legs on, that means back up.
Well, you don't pull on him.
Oh, you just
pick. So you feel just the very slightest bit of tension. Not at all, but like it's there.
Okay.
Like this. You see how there's not much slack?
Right.
In my reins?
Right.
But I'm not pulling on him. Especially because he's pretty sensitive to like your hands.
Right.
So
then I'm probably just way too heavy-handed on him.
And I mean, if you know that, then that gives you something to work on.
Yeah.
You really want to follow with your body and your hands.
Right. I'm learning that.
So you can have that slight
Right.
You're not pulling on him like I was saying.
Right.
He's being really good.
He is.
Good man. You want me to try the camera?
Sure, if you want.
I might down this stretch.
We know he'll do it for you because he has. I just don't want to do it for me yet. I suck at recording. There he goes.
Wasn't his right lead the better way? Do you remember?
He wouldn't take the correct lead going this direction, the way you're going.
Okay.
But I can't tell if he's on the right lead or not by looking at him, so.
Okay. And he wasn't.
He wasn't? That's the same direction he was in before.
I think we were the other way.
No.
No, we weren't. Never mind. I'm crazy.
No, you're not.
You're right.
So is that the right lead?
Yeah.
Yeah?
He said, scary jump.
Yeah. But he didn't do bad. I mean, he just slightly. That was nice. Okay, did you tell him to stop there?
Yeah.
Okay. Because usually if I say good boy, he stops because he wants a treat. Because I try to say good boy instead of yes because that was his word before.
Uh-huh.
And every time I say yes, he wants to stop. Nice, good releases.
He was on the wrong lead, but that's okay. So maybe I'll try this way once. I'm not going to do a whole lot of cantering because right. I know it's hard for him.
It's hard for him, but it's good for him. Very nice. I missed it, my foam at Vori. What happened there?
He was trying to stop at you.
Oh. Bye. That was. He's being so good. I'm very happy.
I'm gonna let him walk for a bit.
Okay.